Hi, this is a lecture on what node voltage is, okay, or voltage at a node. And in order to discuss this, we have to bring up a concept called electrical ground. So if you look at my example that I have here, this diagram, you can see that there's this new symbol right here. Well, this symbol is the electrical ground symbol. Okay, so electrical ground. Okay, and we'll get to what this is all about in just a second, but first notice that I've taken this circuit and I found all the voltages across the resistors. So I just took the original circuit here and I reduced it down to the series circuit. You know, the 3-in-1 are in series, so that's a 4-ohm resistor. The 4 and 8 are in series, so that's a 12. And then this 12 is in parallel with this 4. And if you do product over sum with 12 and 4, you get 48 over 16, which is 3. So that's where this resistor came from. And then I use voltage divider to find that there's 12 volts across this 3-ohm, which means that the balance, 36 minus 12, the 24, has to be across this 6. So in this diagram, there's 24 volts across this 6, and then there's 12 volts across both these series combinations here that are in parallel. So I use voltage divider and KVL again to find the voltage across the resistors. So that's, you know, things that we've done before. But now, quite often, you're interested in what the voltage at a node is. So I've labeled all the nodes in this original circuit here. This is node A, where the 6 ohm connects to the plus side of the voltage source. This is node B up here, this connection. This is node C. This is node D. And then this bottom node we've defined as ground, okay? And again, you can tell that by the symbol here. Okay? So, quite often, you'll want to know, well, what is the voltage at these nodes that we have in our circuits, at these connection points? So you'll hear the term, you know, node voltage, or sometimes, you know, you'll hear an EE or CP say, you know, what the voltage at a node is. Well, remember, voltage is a difference. So when you're asked what the voltage at a node is, you always have to ask the question, well, with respect to what other node, okay, because voltage is a difference. It's very analogous to height, that you know that the height of something is the difference of two heights. You know, if you're asked what the height of Bishop's Peak is, well, you would have to know with respect to what other height. Now, by convention, you know, we would just assume sea level unless we were told something else. That if we're asked the height of something on the surface of the earth, well, we would just have that with respect to sea level because that's the convention. But, you know, the height of Bishop's Peak is much different if you use the center of the earth as your reference point. Well, it's the same sort of thing in circuits with voltage at nodes, that in order to answer the question what the voltage at a node is, you have to know with respect to what other node. Well, that's where electrical ground comes in, that we define a reference node that we call electrical ground. And just like we say there's zero potential energy at sea level when we're using sea level as our reference point for heights, well, electrical ground, we define the electric potential at electrical ground to be zero. Okay, so we define that electrical ground has 0 volts. Okay? So now if I'm asked what the voltage at node A is, okay, and again, in our diagram, node A is this node right here. Well, it's the voltage at that node with respect to ground. So it's the voltage across these two nodes. And in this diagram, since only a 36-volt source is connected between node A and ground, well, node A is going to be 36 volts higher than ground, which is 0. So you see, VA would just be 36 minus 0, because that's the value we assign ground. So VA is 36 volts. Okay. All right. Well, now let's look at node B. Okay, let's say we want to find the voltage at node B. Well, the voltage at node B is the voltage here with respect to ground. Okay? Well, look what's between node A, where we know there's 36 volts, and node B. There's this 6 ohm resistor. And we found out previously that there's 24 volts across that 6 ohm resistor. So you see, as we go from node A to node B, we're changing 24 volts. Okay, 24 volts is dropped across this 6 ohm resistor. So if I'm 36 volts at node A with respect to ground, and I'm changing 24 volts as I go from node A to node B, and the polarity tells me that I'm dropping, right, because see, this is the higher voltage end. So that means that node A is 24 volts higher than node B. So you see, node B would just equal 36 minus 24. So the voltage at node B with respect to ground would be 12 volts. Okay? Which, by the way, is the voltage across this 3 ohm in this diagram, which represents these series parallel connections that we have of these resistors. So you see, it agrees with what we got here. Okay? So now the voltage, say we want the voltage at node C. Okay? Well, the voltage at node C is the voltage at this node with respect to ground. Well, look what's connected between node C and ground. It's this 8 ohm resistor. So the voltage across that 8 ohm resistor, that is the voltage at node C. So you see here, VC would just equal the voltage across the 8 ohm, which we found was 8 volts. Okay, and then node D, okay, that's the node here. So the voltage at this node with respect to ground. Well, what's connected between node D and ground is the 1 ohm resistor. So its voltage just equals the voltage across the 1 ohm resistor, which is 3 volts. Okay, so that's what voltage at a node means. Unless you're told otherwise, you always use ground as your reference point for node voltages. So one last thing here is that sometimes you may want a voltage at a node with respect to another node. With respect to another node that's not ground. So for example, you could be asked, well, what is the voltage at node C with respect to node D? Okay, see, if you don't see a second subscript, like here in these four node voltages, we weren't given a second subscript, so the reference is ground. See, if you don't see a second subscript, then that's what you're using as your reference, is ground. But now, see here, you're asked, well, what is the voltage at node C with respect to node D? So that would equal the voltage at node C with respect to ground minus the voltage at node D with respect to ground. See, it's just the same as getting the difference between two surface heights on the surface of the Earth. Like, say you're comparing the height of Bishop's Peak with the height of Madonna Mountain, right? Both of those heights would be with respect to ground, and the way you would get the difference of those two heights with respect to ground is you would just subtract them. So it's the same type of thing here with voltages at a node, two different nodes with respect to ground. So VC would just be, or VCD, excuse me, would just be 8 minus 3. Right? Because see, VC is 8, VD is 3. So VCD would just be the difference of those two, so 5 volts. And then the polarity of this voltage is that since the voltage at node C is higher than the voltage or yeah, since the voltage at node C is higher than the voltage at node D, see the plus would be on node C. Because remember, the polarity always tells us which is the higher, the plus of the polarity always tells us which is the higher end of the voltage difference. Okay, now, one last thing, and that's, what if we're asked VDC? Okay, we're asked, well, what is the voltage at node D with respect to node C? Well, that's just going to be the opposite of above. It's just going to be VD minus VC. Okay, so now we're going to have 3 minus 8, which is minus 5 volts. So you see, here's the other meaning of a negative voltage. Earlier in the quarter, we talked about how a negative sign in front of a voltage, one meaning of that is that the polarity being shown is really opposite of what it is. But here's another meaning of a negative voltage, is that the reference is at a higher voltage than the node that you're referring it to. So you see how we're using the voltage of node C as a reference, and that's higher than what our the voltage that we're referring to it is equal to. Now, kind of interesting here is that still the polarity would be that the higher voltage is on node C. See, that hasn't changed, right? Because in both cases, you know, VC is the higher voltage. It's just now we're using that higher voltage as the reference, and that's why we get a negative voltage here. So the whole concept here of electrical ground, as you're going to see in the next video, is important, because in the next video we discuss a circuit analysis method. It's a systematic method of analysis, because there's just steps you have to know and rules that you follow, and you're able to get the correct answers solving for, you know, the quantities in a circuit. And one of the major steps of node voltage method, the systematic method of analysis, is that you always have to have a reference node in that analysis method. So we'll be doing more coming up with electrical ground and also node voltages.